All right, people, what is good? Back with another video, and today, you know what time it is. We're going to do the pregame of the Atlanta Falcons game as we go up against the Washington football team. Last week was pretty enjoyable to watch, to say the least. For the most part, it was a little shaky, but the Falcons pulled out a win, and you have to take these wins one step at a time. That's just what you have to do. Whatever type of win it is, if it's a win, it's a win. So we're going to try to go for two in a row, going to go on up against the Washington football team, and looks like we can have success against this team. I think this game is a very winnable game, especially if we piggyback off of what we did last week. The defense, I'm not necessarily going to highlight the defense too much in this pregame because I don't have many concerns about the defense going up against this Washington team. I could be wrong, but if they continue to build off what they did last week, I have no problem with what they did, what they can do. I have no problem. I have no concerns for the most part. I want to see more pass rush. AJ Terrell is going to be back. So with that being said, our secondary should be better because AJ Terrell has done a phenomenal job throughout this season prior to his injury. I mean, not many passes came his way. And the game, the play that he got injured on, he made a phenomenal play to defend a pass by Tom Brady. So we're going to see how the defense plays out. I think they're going to be fine, so I'm not really going to address that. What I want to address is the offensive line, keeping Matt Ryan upright and getting the ball into the hands of guys like Cordell Patterson and Kyle Pitts. Not too much. I'm not thinking too much about Calvin Ridley and Zacchaeus so much. I would like for them to get the ball, and I think they'll be able to change the game if they do get the ball, but I know for certain, as of so far this year, if you can get the ball to Cordell Patterson or you get it to Kyle Pitts, we can make some things happen. So hopefully that'll be the case. They'll be able to get the ball to them early. I know that there's a lot of focus on Kyle Pitts, but I would like to see them get the ball to him early. Try to get, you know, some type of establishment of the passing game in this game. When you look at the defense of the Washington football team, people talk about their front seven, and their front seven is really good. And I don't think it's going to be anything close to what happened last week when they played against the Bills, because against the Bills, they did not touch Josh Allen at all. I don't think they didn't touch him at all. Zero sacks. I think they got, you know, the defense got some tackles, obviously, because they're going to tackle some people. But as far as sack, they didn't get to touch Josh Allen. Now, that I don't think that's going to be the case in this game, because our offensive line is still suspect. Even though Matt Ryan, I don't think Matt Ryan was touched. I don't think he got sacked last week, but we're going up against this particular team. It could be a possibility that these guys are going to give up a couple of sacks. Matt Ryan, it could be a situation where he's possibly running for his life. This is why I said that it's real important to try to keep Matt Ryan upright. If you keep Matt Ryan upright, I think we're going to be just absolutely fine. We're going to be good if that's the case. Have no issues on that end at all. So that's pretty much, you know, basic stuff when it comes to, you know, if you can control the line, you can control the trenches, you can control keeping your quarterback protected, big things will happen for your teams. They will happen. You know what I'm saying? It's just plain and simple. You know, as far as the defense goes, once again, the defense front seven going up against the Washington football team, I think we can get some pressure. We did a good job against getting pressure on some really good offensive linemen so far. You know, as far as, you know, the Bucs, we got some pressure, got Tom Brady a couple times, got Daniel Jones a few times, and we got him in a critical moment. So we can get to Taylor Heinicke. Heinicke is so much of a, you know, he's kind of an unknown talent still to this day. He can play some ball. He really can. I like him a lot. I was a big fan of him getting the starting job at Washington based on the playoff game that he played against the Bucs. So I just feel that our defensive line, our front seven, can get up on them and actually, you know, we can get up on them and actually, you know, do some things against them. So I'm not really concerned. Like I said, I'm not really concerned about the defense. I'm not. I mean, it could come back to bite me, and I know a lot of people saying, like, hey, you know, our defense is this, is our that, you know, Matt Ryan's this and that, and I get it. You know, a lot of people are saying things about the team, and I understand it. It is what it is. You know, and I'm going to correct myself. Let me see. Matt Ryan was sacked 3 times in his last game. So it just goes to show you. Let me correct myself. Matt Ryan was sacked 3 times in the game. So that just goes to show you. We really need to find a way to do more as far as protecting Matt Ryan. If we could protect him just enough for him to get the ball out, I think good things will happen. So with that being said, I hope that we'll be able to get that done as far as protection. Running the ball, that's one way that we could, what we can do to neutralize that pass, the rushing attack. Maybe we can run the ball. I'm not really sure. I want to look at the Bills. I want to look at their stats and see what happened when Washington did play the Buffalo Bills. I don't think the Bills ran the ball as much as I think. The score was 21-43, and the Bills did not run the ball very much. I mean, Zach Moss had 60 yards. So, it was all about the passing. Josh Allen threw for 358. But like I said, Josh Allen was not touched at all. You know, excuse me. He wasn't touched at all. So when the quarterback is upright and he's able to see across the field and he's not being touched, big things are happening. And that's what we need to do. Like I said, defensively, I don't have a really big concern when it comes to the defense, us playing defense against, you know, the Washington football team. I'm not too worried about that. I think offensively, you know, I don't think they're going to be good enough to put up many points against our defense, but it's what we do. Can we establish the passing game? Can we establish the run? Can we neutralize that pass rush with the run? Can we do things to put points on the board? And that's where I go back to say getting the hands of guys like Cordell Patterson, because Cordell Patterson does so much. He runs the ball out the backfield. He can catch out the backfield. He can run routes as a receiver. He does so much. So if we can get the ball in his hands, I think he's going to be the reason why we come out on top. Hopefully that'll be the case. And I'll be back with a post-game show, and hopefully we'll be talking about a W, just like we did yesterday with the Georgia Southern game. Yay. Ha, ha, ha. If you like this video, hit the like button. Hit share this video. Let people know what I'm doing over here. Also, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Shout out to everybody in Eagle Nation. Guys came over to subscribe to the channel lately after the big win of against Arkansas State. You guys are awesome. Shout out to the guys on Patreon. You're great as well. And everybody who's been hitting, you know, the like button, the share button, everybody who's been coming through commenting, you guys are great. I really, really appreciate it. You guys are awesome, and I really mean that. Almost at 1,000 subs. We're chugging right along. So hopefully we see you guys on the next one. Hopefully we have a win to talk about. All right, y'all. Y'all be blessed. Peace.